आई एम प्रोफेसर पीएस बारावकर. ओके, टुडे वी सी एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर सेकंड ऑफ सब्जेक्ट हाइड्रोलिक्स एंड न्यूमेटिक्स. द टाइटल ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट सेकंड इज एनालिसिस ऑफ द हाइड्रोलिक सर्किट्स ऑन हाइड्रोलिक ट्रेनर किट. So in that experiment we see analysis of a hydraulic circuits. So first one, introduction, analysis of the following hydraulic circuit on the hydraulic trainer. In that experiment we analyze the different circuits on hydraulic trainer kit. So in that, first circuit is a regenerative circuit. Okay. First circuit is a regenerative circuit, and second one is a sequencing circuit, speed control circuit, transverse and field circuit. So those circuit we can analyze by on hydraulic trainer. Okay, so one by one we discuss. First one is what is a regenerative circuit. So first one is a regenerative circuit. So in a hydraulic system we can withdraw different types of circuits. So first one is in a regenerative circuit. In a regenerative circuit, in this circuit the 4x3 directional control wall is used in a such a way that the return line from the rod end side, instead of being connected to the tank line, is connected back to the supply line of a DC wall as shown. Okay, so in a regenerative circuit we use 4x3. 4 means 4 position and 3 port. Okay, 4 position, 4 port and 3 positions. So DC wall we can use in a regenerative circuit. So application of regenerative circuit is to obtain equal speed in both direction, rapid advantage of the cylinder. Okay, so in a circuit diagram we see that, so this circuit diagram shows, suppose all of you know this is a tank, it is also known as a reservoir. After that we can connect a pump, this is symbol of pump. After that, directional control wall we can use. This is a directional control wall, 4x3 directional control wall we can use here. Okay, so this line is a suction line, this line is a suction line, this line is suction line. After that, this is DCV wall, DCV, this is a pressure relief wall. And in a directional control wall, 4x3 directional control wall we can use. In 4x3 directional control wall means 4 position and 4 port and 3 positions. Okay, so this connection, first connection is connected in an actuator inlet side, and second one is in a return line. Okay, this is a return line, this is suction line. So this connection is connected in a directional control wall. Okay, and a return line is directly connected to direct connected, and this circuit is completed, a return circuit. So that type of circuit is known as a regenerative circuit. We can use a return line pressure also we can use in a system. Okay, so this is whole circuit is a regenerative circuit. So those are the basic component of a circuit. Suppose reservoir, pump, hydraulic pump, suction pipe, pressure relief wall, directional control wall, suction line and return line, actuator. In that we can use a single acting actuator. Actuator has a two type of actuator we can see. First one is a single acting and double acting. In that figure we use a single acting actuator. So this is a circuit, a regenerative circuit. So next circuit is a speed control circuit. So in speed control, some operations are related to machining of the complex profiles which required slow speed while drilling, reaming, grinding, as well as for multi-point cutting operation. need this speed. And for the return stroke, which is said to ideal stroke, required fast speed as there is no any productive movement of the tool. So this is a speed control circuit. In a speed control circuit, there are three type of circuit. First one is a meter in circuit, meter out circuit, and bleed off circuit. So what is a meter in circuit? Meter in circuit means we can use a flow control valve in between actuator and in between a directional control valve and actuator. So all of you see, this is a circuit diagram of a speed control circuit. So in that, this is a reservoir, this is a pump, okay, and this is a pressure relief valve. We can use here directional control valve, 4x2 directional control valve we can use here. After that, this is a flow control valve, FCV, this is symbol of flow control valve, and this flow control valve is mounted in between directional control valve and actuator on a suction line. Okay, so we control the pressure or flow of a fluid on a suction line or inlet of actuator. So that type of control circuit is known as meter in circuit. So this is a type of speed control circuit, meter in circuit. This is the actuator. Okay, this is return line. So a flow control valve is mounted in a suction line. So that type of circuit is known as meter in circuit. There are three type of speed control circuit: meter in circuit, meter out circuit, and bleed off. So first we see meter in circuit. We can mounted a flow control valve in between suction line, inlet line. That's why it is known as a meter in circuit. For example, suppose we can use flow control valve on a return line. In that position we use suppose flow control valve. So that type of circuit is known as meter out circuit. Okay, meter out circuit. So this is a diagrammatic circuit diagram of a speed control circuit. Next one is a sequence circuit, sequencing circuit. In a sequencing circuit, when the number of actuator linear type are operated one after another in a predetermined order, okay, it is known as a sequencing circuit. Sequencing of number of cylinder in a particular sequence is required for work movement in a machine tools, jigs, and fixture. So that type of circuit is a sequencing circuit. In a simple way, number of actuators are operated one after another in predetermined order. It is known as sequencing circuit. So this is a circuit diagram of sequencing circuit. Same symbolic presentation. The first one is a reservoir, pump, pressure relief valve, directional control valve, actuator, okay, suction line. So those are the cylinder, spring operated cylinder, first cylinder, second cylinder, okay. So in a sequencing circuit, both the actuator is operated one another continuously. So that type of circuit is known as sequencing circuit. So this is a circuit diagram of sequencing circuit. Next circuit is a transverse and field circuit. In a transverse and field circuit, the operation where required heavy force and rapid to and fro movement, these circuits are based. It consists of the oil reservoir, pump, motor, and control valves intensifier. The reservoir contains oil meter drives the pump which pressurizes the oil to the required pressure limit. Okay, so this type of circuit is a transfer circuit. The transfer circuit, it consists of same reservoir, motor, control valves, intensifier. Okay. So this is a circuit diagram of a transverse and field circuit. Same, it consists of reservoir, pumps, directional control valve. In that circuit diagram, you show this is directional 4x3 directional control valve. Okay, this is a 1 minute. Okay. So those are the component of transverse and field circuit. So it consists of a reservoir, pump, directional control valve, actuator, intensifier. Sorry, this instrument is known as intensifier. Intensifier, and this is application based circuit diagram of a transverse and field circuit. This is a pressure relief valve. Okay. So, and this is a conclusion. In this experiment there are various circuits like a regenerative circuit, sequencing circuit, speed control circuit, transverse field circuit. We studied by using hydraulic trainer kit. So this is a conclusion of this experiment. In that experiment we analyze regenerative circuit, sequencing circuit, speed control circuit, transverse speed circuit, transverse field circuit. Okay, we studied and analyzed using hydraulic trainer kit. Okay, thank you.